Days confused.
Slacker.
Before sunrise and before sunset.
Me and Orson.
A Scanner Darkly. I was like, what?
Newton Boys.
Tape.
Suburbia.
Waking Life.
Before Midnight.
Bernie.
School of Rock.
And then there's the Bad News Bears.
K.A.T. Prince Valiant. Richard Linklater.
He's a nice guy.
He just makes it all look so easy.
He's a but he's like, and you know, he's great.
Rick as a director kind of sneaks up on you.
He's a sneaky Shakespeare.
Very wise and very laid back.
He's onto something special that's unique to him.
He's just a regular dude.
There's nothing about Rick that's ugly. He doesn't have like an ugly bone in him.
He really just gathers people around with his mind somehow. It's weird.
That's one of the most inspirational things about his career is that he is constantly changing and fearless in his approach to each project that he does.
As soon as he knows enough about one thing, he goes on to what he doesn't necessarily know everything about, and he discovers it through his filmmaking. And it's really fantastic. He's just wandering around going from interesting thing to interesting thing, whatever piques his interest, and then nails it.
The patience, the calm, the zen. He's the master. He is one of these guys that just is nauseated by formula or by cliche or anything you've seen a million times. He won't do it. He won't do it, and he takes you down some new roads.
I'm part of a generation of directors that basically came right after Soderbergh and Linklater and a bunch of independent directors who paved the road for American independent cinema. He opens with this film, Slacker, that is unlike anything I'd ever seen and probably unlike anything most people who saw it had ever seen.
He got his friends out. He had some ideas. He threw them together as roughly as he could. He wasn't really a filmmaker at the time. Yeah. You know, he was a philosopher who chose celluloid to do some funny and interesting stuff.
You just kind of stream of consciousness. And that's what Slacker does. You meet this boy in a taxi cab. And you're like, okay, I guess the movie's about this guy who had a weird dream. And really, he's setting you up for the whole movie. He tells you what you're about to see. And it's beautiful because that's the director, Richard Linklater.
Every thought you have creates its own reality. You know, it's like every choice or decision you make, the thing you choose not to do fractions off and becomes its own reality, you know, and just goes on from there.
I was running a little independent theater company, and one of the guys in the play that we were doing was in Dazed and Confused. His name's Anthony Rapp, and he's a great actor. And Rick came to see Anthony in our play. And before that had happened, before Rick came, Anthony said, hey, you want to go see an advanced screening of this movie I'm in, Dazed and Confused? It's the guy who directed Slacker. And I was like, yeah, okay. And that was the first time, Dead Poets Society came out when I was 18, and so I was pretty amused with myself in a lot of ways. And I saw that movie, I almost couldn't enjoy it. I wanted to be inside that movie. I wanted to be that movie. I was so jealous.
Hey guys, stay with me because I've got a really interesting movie fact from Taxi Driver. The dialogue in the most iconic scene, you're talking to me, wasn't actually written in the script. Robert De Niro completely improvised the whole thing. As the screenplay said, Travis speaks to himself in the mirror. Well, obviously not. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to keep up to date. And remember, one hand washes the other. Bye-bye.